This is Kalia. She's a Western hoolock gibbon, one of the rarest apes in the world. Kalia lives in a forest in northeastern India. Local people say they used to see her with a mate and her offspring. What happened to them? No one knows. Now Kalia is alone. Except she isn't. Kalia has a friend, a man named Ninda. It was he who gave her her name. She lives wild in the trees around his house, but she's always close by. It's not about food, it's about the company. Gibbons are highly social animals and spend hours grooming, touching, and communicating. So in the absence of other apes, it seems Kalia's turned to her human neighbor. Most days she visits for an hour or two, interacting with Ninda, grooming him and making his space her own. The hoolock gibbon has lived in the forests of Assam for millennia. Like most apes, they live in tight-knit troops, family units that live, feed, and breed in the forest canopy. The young stay with their parents until they're old enough to strike out and start a new troop of their own. These apes once ranged far across the northeast of India. But over the past few centuries, people have moved in, transforming the landscape from forest to farmland. Many hoolock gibbon troops have found themselves hemmed in by this human expansion. Villages, roads, and train tracks sectioning off the forest. As family members die off, there are few new apes to meet. Leaving a gibbon like Kalia stranded on the edge of the human world. Her innate drive to socialize has led her to this family. She's clearly in charge. Even the family dogs submit to her grooming, perhaps hoping they'll get a belly rub in the bargain. Grooming between apes is, in part, a way of building trust and establishing alliances. So this is Kalia's way of signaling that she's accepted this family as her own and receiving assurance back that she is welcome. In short, Ninda's family are surrogate apes. And when visitors come calling, She inspects and grooms them as if she's head of the household.
This is really like an exotic head massage. Yep.
And that includes our film crew.
Let me just clarify that this is a wild gibbon. She lives free. She's not a pet. She just happens to come to this house because she's got habituated to this place. And, well, she loves people, clearly, and people are her family. And she also seems to be finding all kinds of things in my hair, which is slightly worrying. She's using three limbs.
This touching connection between an ape and her human may be unusual. But when it comes to modern-day India, cohabitation is the new reality.